WCAA, your local connection for news, traffic, weather, and sports. AM 1050, KCAA.
Hello, and welcome to Let's Go Shopping with Bev. This show brought to you by Starflight Entertainment. Music by Dr. Bombay and the Blue Machine Band. Song title, Living in Paradise. Now here's Bev.
Well, welcome to the show, everybody. And Eric is working the board for us. Hi, Eric. And
happy Friday, Eric.
Hello, ladies. How's it going?
Good. And Eric is going to play a very special tune for us. And turn it up a little bit, Eric, because we have three fantastic ladies in the house. And this song goes out to them. And the 5,000 trillion, gillion, billion people that are behind you. We have Kathy, we have Nancy, and we have Vicky. And these ladies are from the Believe Walk right here in Redlands. They're out there with all of us doing a walk on Sunday, October 7th, right here in lovely Redlands, California. And we're going to go out there and we are going to beat and walk away this nasty disease. So right now I'm going to be quiet. We're going to hear a little bit of your song, ladies.
All right, that song sure brings back memories.
Here it is, ladies. Enjoy it.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
A singer in a snow-capped room. A smell of wine and cheap perfume.
It's all about inland women fighting cancer.
It certainly is. And we're doing a darn good job, aren't we?
We couldn't do a better job, I'll tell you.
Yes.
Let's hear it to Believing, because that's what it's all about.
Yes,
believing in the cause, believing in you can do it, believing in helping others, believing in uniting to beat that nasty disease, cancer.
Yes, and ladies, thank you for coming to the show today. And it means a lot to all of us, because all of us have gone through it. Our family members gone, and some are still going through it. So, you know, we're going to do the best. Now, ladies, who would like to be the first spokesperson?
Well, I'd like to just say thank you so much for inviting us here today. We're excited to be here and tell you about our walk and tell you a little bit about our story and how it got started and where we're hoping it will be on Sunday, October 7th.
Well, it's going to be quite crowded, and there's everybody and their brother
yes,
is going to be down there, huh?
And that's what makes it exciting. And what people may or may not know is it's the fifth annual. So this started back 5 years ago, and this is like a celebratory year.
It is our fifth annual. It has been quite a wonderful journey for us. It started in 2007 when we hoped we might have about 400 or 500 people, and we had an amazing turnout of 1,700 people, which was a good problem and a bad problem.
I don't think it was a bad problem, do you?
Well, we just had to scurry around and get more T-shirts printed and more water and more vendors.
It's when they had this dream, they just never dreamed that it would blossom into something so unique and beautiful and that so many people would come together. And I think that's what happens when you involve so much faith in.
Well, when Kathy and Annie and I came together and had this idea to do this walk, it definitely was a dream. And the dream has just been supplemented by a wonderful committee called Inland Women Fighting Cancer. Mm-hmm. And they're an amazing group of women that we're a kind of a funny committee. We don't have bylaws. We don't have rules, we don't have dues, but it's a committee of very impassioned women that work very hard to put on this walk, because the money raised from this walk truly helps the people here in the Inland Empire. All the money we raise here stays here to help our people here.
I think Nancy and Annie and I realized while we were being treated for our cancers that the area needed help. And there were so many different hospitals or clinics in the area in the Inland Empire that needed certain imaging equipment, just helping women with their problems of you know, what they do next and who do they go to and what is this all about. And they needed a lot of answers to all their questions. And so we are just thrilled that we've had the turnout these last 4 years, and we're hoping for even bigger turnout this year.
Well, what I noticed is when I got involved with all of you, excuse me, because of this fantastic lady, and which is our liaison, yay, we got a liaison, Christina. And that's how I got involved in it. And then when Diane was with us and she got involved with it, well, last year I could not actually, you see it, but it doesn't penetrate until afterwards, and you get thinking about it, and you're going, I don't believe this just happened. The amount of people and the energy that you felt in that area, and being on the air and talking to you all and getting involved with this. And then last year, you all invited me to help do the poster boards and all of that with all the feathers and the glue and stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, we were laughing so hard. We had a good time. And that one lady, I cannot remember what her name was. And her husband was a doctor. He was a plastic surgeon. And she ended up getting glue all over her. And I felt like we were a bunch of little kids in nursery school, you know, playing with this stuff. But it was absolutely fabulous. And when I left there, and then after the walk, that stuck with me. And I'm going, if they got through it, I'm going to get through it. And so, and it continues. But I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for everything that you ladies did. And I'm going to tell every listener out there, I don't care how old, young you are, how rich, how poor, whatever it is. If you have an idea and you can feel it in your toes that you want to start an organization or you want to start your own business, whatever it is, get up off the couch, stop talking about it, and go and do it. That's what happened to these ladies back in 07. And look at what they accomplished. If they can do it, anybody can do it. So come on, let's go, America. Let's get in there and just go get it done.
You know, I think what makes this so unique, though, Inland Women Fighting Cancer, and then, of course, they teamed up and part of now get to be a part of Stata Brothers Charities, who's been instrumental in really bringing it to the forefront as well. But what makes it so unique is these three ladies actually have a common bond in that they have experienced it in their lives personally. And it's sort of like when you're going through anything in life, when you can talk to somebody that has actually experienced it, it makes all the difference in the world. But there goes the passion or you know, compassion, the passion, the drive. I think it's even inner, you know, more of your inner spirit is more involved. So it's going to blossom and kind of flourish and just turn into what it's turned into. But I think what would be fun is, since Bev mentioned the posters, why don't you tell the listeners what the posters are all about?
I'd love to talk about it. Our Believe Walk is a very grassroots kind of feel to it. We do have poster parties, and we do have different ways people in the community can be involved in creative ways and fun ways to help celebrate life, to help celebrate our walk. And this year, for the first time, we have a student poster contest.
Oh, really?
Yeah, where the high school and junior high and some special education classes have been sent an invitation to participate in our poster contest, and we are very excited to see what these kids are going to come up with. They're so creative, and we're just thrilled to have that that added to our event. We try, on State Street, we try to have about 500 posters, and I was thrilled when I looked back at pictures last year of people actually out on the walk, and they were carrying posters, and when I realized they were posters that they had taken down from the beginning of the walk, and they carried them with. And so that was kind of a fun thing.
That's cool. That's cool. Yeah. And I like that. Who was the one at the end of the walk over there at the park? And you had that Jeep. with all the bras on it.
Oh, our support van.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. Now, that was the coolest thing.
Inland women need support. Yes, yeah. Absolutely.
You know what? And don't you have, like, a bra and tie contest, too? And
we
that,
do.
As a matter of fact, we do. Kathy?
We do. Well, we're inviting everybody to honor a man or a woman or a child or anybody in their family or a friend to be very creative to make a tie or a bra and just decorate it to your heart's content. And we're having them on display at J.D. Myers on State Street in Redlands. And she's got a wonderful window that's going up, and it'll be judged. Mm-hmm. And, Nancy, when was that judging?
Oh, the details, yes. Actually, you can submit bras or ties that have been decorated starting now. The contest has already started. And you can deliver them up until October 4th. So get creative and decorate and get your bras and ties down there. We have amazing prizes. We award prizes for first, second, and third, and also a People's Choice bra. So it's really a lot of fun. And if you're really not one of the creative types, please come down to J.D. Myers and see them.
And vote for your
yes,
favorite one.
See
it's
them
so
and vote.
Much fun to see all that. And, you know, Bev and I was talking about all the different craft stores, and maybe we're going to talk about it a little bit later, but get down there and, you know, get creative.
And it's so easy. Think outside the box.
Definitely.
You know, really. Yes. And that's one thing. That's where everything starts happening. And if you think, well, I wasn't raised or this way and I can't do this, can't do that, no. Get your juices going, get your brain going, look at it, put as much bling and feathers and whatever you want on this. The gaudier it is, the better it's going to be, honey. Just don't get the glue stuck in your hair.
Nancy, what were you going to say?
Well, a lot of our bras and ties that have been submitted in the past tell stories about people's cancer journeys also.
Yes.
And yes, we have lots of very fun, blingy, bright bras, and, mm-hmm. and it's a lot of fun, but it also is a reminder of why we're in this, why we have to have this walk, that we are, you know, in the fight against cancer and trying to help our friends and neighbors, and frankly, we're all in it together. So
we are. And what the one thing that I would like to find out, I don't think I ever will. I don't think anybody has an answer. I really don't. But when you think, when we're all born, right, and we seem like we're doing okay. We're in the nursery, and we're playing with the other babies and, you know, all this other stuff. And as the years go on, bada-bing, bada-boom, you start getting sick. You go to the doctors, and they say you have this, this, and this, and this, right? Well, we're adults, or somewhat adults, and we can handle it. What really bothers me the most is when you see the little tiny babies and the small toddlers and the children that have this. That's what chews me up more than anything else.
It's very, very difficult. But Kathy and Annie and I, from the beginning, we have always felt that all things are possible for one who believes. Mm-hmm. And we have the three of us and our committee, we just have a faith in the higher power in God, and we believe that our walk is going to help people. Our walk actually, the money we raise isn't just for breast cancer. It isn't just for a specific cancer. It's to help people with any kind of cancer, children and adults alike.
And that's what I love about it, because it's straight across. You know what I mean? And folks, where we crack jokes about this every once in a while, I think that's a good release for anybody and everybody. But if you have anyone or know of anyone that is going through this, please call these ladies. Come on down. You are going to have a good time. I'm going to tell you, the music and the excitement through the air and the decorations and the food and everything. And then at the end, when you get down to the park, and Stater Brothers always has these big
bash at the
there pool. With the goodie bags, as I call them. We every year there's some